from all around your lawn. I'm gonna tell you how football is. Good morning and welcome back to the GDFL Netball Show. Interleague day today, but firstly we're going to have a look at the A-grade ladder and where things are sitting after round seven. So getting close to halfway through the season, but not quite. Where are we sitting at? Out in front, undefeated there and really looking strong. Second, we've got Bell Post Hill, just dropped the one game against Werribee. But this is where East Geelong have dropped back. They were sitting on second on the ladder, but after losing last week to Bell Post Hill.
So you've got Inverleigh East and Bannockburn all on 20 points there, with only percentage separating them.
And Winchelsea's only out, sitting on 16 points. So depending on what happens in the second half of the year, it'll be interesting to see what happens. And goal shooters?
Yeah, Kim Martin, 37 on the weekend, takes her tally to 314, followed closely by Melody Philpott. Scored 36 for 240, which is only a difference of 74 goals, which I think is great for Melody to really catch up on Kim. So
yeah.
I don't know about this 1,000 goals this year, Kim, what's happening? I don't think we're going to get there somehow. Yeah. But anyway, yeah, so you got those two leaders, followed by Erin Schaefer and then Brooke Young.
Yeah. So having a look at the Interleague teams this weekend, this year played at North Geelong. So in Geelong, guys, it'd be great if you could all get down and have a look. It's against the North Central Netball Association, and we just want to welcome the president, Rhoda Allen, who's brought down the teams to play. Having a look at the Interleague team is a combination of last year's team of the year, and they've had to add some extras, obviously, with girls leaving the GDFL competition and
mass walkout.
massive exodus. Anyway, look, in goal shooter position, we've got Mel Philpott from Thompson working with goal attack Kim Martin from Bell Post Hill. Height, girls.
Yeah.
Absolute. You know, it's going to be really interesting to see how they've gone. And it would have been nice to have a chat to see how training's gone with those girls. I know that
they had training last week, but due to commitments with some of the girls with BNL on a Wednesday night, that they only got a few there.
Yep.
So just had a quick chat. Move the balls around a bit, but
so is it fair to say, Mel, that they haven't really trained together as a team much?
They haven't trained at all together.
Okay, so that's fair to say. That's true. That's really true.
Yeah. I think they'll be okay. You know, like, it'll be different. Kim playing with Melody.
Yeah.
She's not me, but she's a big player. It'll be different for Kim, different for Melody, but they'll figure that out pretty quickly.
And Kim, obviously, majority of the time, Mel plays goal shooter with you, where she's coming out to the goal attack, which she can move beautifully and whatever. She can move it down the court. But, you know, stepping back to have that tall goal shooter playing with her, so it'll be interesting.
Yeah, Kim has played a couple of times out at goal attack when I've played centre or back into goal shooter. We do try and mix it around. Kim loves goal attack.
Yep.
She's athletic and agile and she can move, so she'll love that opportunity.
And she's got a big support in Mel Philpott. This kid is only young, let's face it, girls, but the
great
talent of her, the build of her, the height of her, and let alone her accuracy of goals, Kim has got nothing to worry about passing into her at all.
No, and you've got the midcourt around her that Kim's really familiar with, but they'll feed it into her beautifully.
So having a look at the midcourt, we've got Casey Carroll in the attack from Bell Post Hill, followed by Sharon Ford Centre from Bannockburn, and Sharon won
the GDFL
Margaret Webb
medal last year.
So she's sitting in centre.
Both really strong midquarters. That's a terrific combination.
Yeah, and starting up the defence, we've got Erica Shippers from East Geelong. Goal defence, we've got Mel Bragg, who can move back down into the shooting position if it's not working up there. And goalkeeper Elise Devoy from Bell Post Hill.
She plays. Heard a few rumours during the week. Just have to see if she takes the court, really.
What are those rumours?
What was it, Mel? Something
not sure.
About a maybe finger or something?
No,
fractured something.
Elise did injure a finger and is just waiting to see on some XO results. So.
Yep, so we'll see if she takes it.
Just on the wing defence position as well, Erica Shippers, she's got, she plays wing attack a fair bit for East, but in the A&L on a Wednesday night, has the build and body for a really strong wing defence, so that'd be interesting. Melissa Bragg also does play the wing defence position and shooter, as you said, so pretty versatile.
Team,
And looking onto the bench, we've got Justine Radford from Bannockburn, Kate Shippers from East Geelong, and Amanda Wilson from Werribee. Werribee sitting top of the ladder, undefeated, one player in the Interleague team. And I know this is off last year and that,
you know, obviously they didn't make the team of the year.
But it would have been nice to have someone in to explain that to us, really. Fee, like, as you said, like, they're sitting on top of the ladder. You've got one representative from that team. Look at Mick Ward, where are they? Like, you know, why weren't they included, or were there other commitments that they had to do? Unfortunately, we haven't been told, because no one's come in to represent and to sort of explain that to us. Would have been nice. But, yeah, so that's interesting to find that combination and just to find out actually why we haven't got more.
I think in the original team of the year, Danny Stewart made that, and due to her moving on, but Amanda Wilson and Danny would have to be their top players, you know. So Amanda will represent Werribee well.
Of course. Absolutely. And Heidi Shaw is the coach this year out there. She's from Bannockburn. Would have been nice to have her on, but unfortunately it didn't happen. Also got the junior teams playing. So under-17s.
Yes, under-17 we've got Jess
Mapalangi.
Whatever, yeah. From my team of Anarchy.
We've she's playing really well up in B grade, Jess.
She's playing A grade, sorry. Actually, yes. And I think she had one game in B grade.
Yeah.
But, yeah, really coming forward. Look, she's only young. She'll get there. We've got Katrina Felice from Winch. We've got Michaela, no, excuse me if I get these names wrong, but Balti from Winch will see too. Holly Elville from Werribee, Emily Warhol from Bannockburn, Grace Bath from Bannockburn, Darcy Scarlett from Belmont, and also Sammy Nelson from Belmont. Congratulations, girls, on making the team, and I hope you do well today.
Absolutely.
As Cogsy says,
he's fist pumping here because he's so excited about the Belmont girls being there. So,
yeah.
Just want to say a big thank you to you girls for today. Mel coming in and taking out the shoes of Amanda.
No worries. Yeah.
And also, Fiona, before we go, also to the under-15s, good luck to you two girls.
Absolutely.
On getting on, all you girls, well done on getting in the team, and we also hope you do well.
Yeah, and to all the interleague teams, so if you can get down there to the North Geelong, not 100% sure of the times, but...
I think last year it was 2 o'clock, so it'd be the same.
So that's A grade, 2
would be o'clock. Fantastic if you get down there and support the girls. It'd be a great game to watch, and the skill base there is just a great representation. Of
And
the
rug league. Up, because it's bloody cold down there in North Geelong. That wind, shocking.
Absolutely. Anyway, it's over to Dick and the boys on the footy show.
From all around you long, I'm gonna tell you how football is strong.